This is Destiny Matters. Every man is born for a particular purpose, and it's God's pleasure to help you become it. Welcome to Destiny Matters. And now, your host, author, pastor, and speaker, Charles Cassivante.
Praise the Lord. In the Bible, this morning, by the way, I shared, you can go online and find out, I shared between what's the distinction between praise and worship. Praise has got to do with celebration of God. What God has done. Worship is about exaltation and reverence. Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibwe.
So praise is usually talking about God's nature.
Tuba tuogela kuchikula cha Katonda.
God's attributes.
Ebyo ebimukwatako.
God, who God is.
Katonda chichari.
Before he does anything.
Ngataina akoche yakoze.
By nature,
mubutonde bwe.
God has got his character.
Katonda ine mbalaye.
God has got his attributes.
Katonda ina ebimukwatako.
Some of the things that make him God.
Ebimukubimufula Katonda.
Is that he's omniscient.
Nti kubanga amanyi
is knows. He knows all.
He's
omnipotent.
Katonda ina amanya
full of all power. He's omnipresent. Present everywhere at all times. God is love.
Katonda kuagala.
In him there's no hatred.
Muyete muli kuchawa.
God is holy.
Katonda mutukuvu.
In him there's no sin.
Muyete muli chibi.
God is righteous.
Katonda mutukirivu.
Never with an idea of turning from being right.
Ngatasobola wadde okuchuka okuva ku kitufu.
So in him there's no wrong.
Kati muyete muli
kichamu. You can never find wrongdoing in God.
Tosobola kuzula nsobi obakola buchamu mu
Katonda. He's a righteous God.
Ye Katonda omutukirivu.
By nature he's righteous.
Muchikula che ye Katonda mutukirivu.
In God there is no deception.
Mu Katonda temuli bulimba.
Because he's a just God.
Kubanga Katonda wa mazima.
There is no corruption.
Temuli corruption.
He's a God who's just.
Ye Katonda wa mazima.
And God is a good God.
Era Katonda mulungi.
There's no evil in him.
Taina bubi muye.
He's a good God.
Ye Katonda mulungi.
Our God is immutable.
Katonda wa fe tachuka chuka.
Exactly. He never changes.
Tachuka chuka.
His nature is standard.
Echikula chete chichuka chuka.
By nature God is compassionate.
Muchikula Katonda asasira.
Compassionate means he moves in love.
Okusasira chitegezo mukwano gumutambo gumuchusa.
God is merciful.
Katonda wachisira.
That's why he looks upon sinners and has mercy.
Chovola batunulira abononyi nabasasira.
God is a God of power.
Katonda wamanyi.
God is infinite.
Katonda waluberera.
He is without measure.
Chuka teyenkanika taina chigero.
Cannot say is this height, is this width.
Tosobola gamba nti mugazi bwati oba muwanvu bwati.
You cannot say is heavy like this.
Tosobola gamba mbwazito wa bwati.
God is eternal.
Katonda wa luberera.
It means
chitegeza.
He has always been.
Bulijjo yalingawo.
And he will always be.
Era bulijjo aliberawo.
God is gracious.
Katonda asasira.
That what means?
Ekigambo ekyo chitegeza.
That God gives gifts.
Nti Katonda agaba ebirabo.
God is wisdom.
Katonda magezi.
All these things are who God is.
Bino byonna byebitubuulira ki Katonda kyali.
When we praise him.
Kati bwe tubanga tumutendereza.
Even for just one of his attributes. We are telling him. We have seen that who you said you are is who you are.
Isaiah 25
and verse number 1. The Bible says, the Lord my God is the God of Israel. He is my God. 25 and verse 1 of Isaiah. He is my God. And I'll praise him. I'll praise his name for the wonders he has done. Because he brings to pass the things that were told about in the old. NIV, please. Those things that were spoken about in the old days, the Lord brings them to pass.
Katonda bitukiriza.
Because he is God.
Kubanga ye Katonda.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibwe.
This morning we talked about faith praise. But I don't do it, but let me just explain it. Faith praise is praising God in a situation, knowing that even if it's not yet changed, I know God will change it. So you praise Him for what you have not yet seen. Remember Acts 16, Paul and Cyrus, how they praised in chains. This morning we even learned they were wounded, they had chains, but they still praised. So praise is not only for what God is doing, it is also because we know He's going to do it.
Again, that bikola.
Somebody declare with all your power,
Langiri, omuntu omu na manyi gogona.
I know He's going to do it.
Nze manyi nti agenda kuchikola.
You're going to say it better than say, I know.
Gamba manyi.
God is going to do it.
Katonda agenda chikola.
That is why I'll praise Him.
Chovola banja mutendereza.
So we saw that when they sang hymns in the midnight hour,
era ne tulaba nti bwe bayimba nyimba ezokutendereza Katonda mu kiro, enzigi
and they began to see the Lord. Then worship is about reverence. It's about exaltation. It has nothing to do with what God is doing. It has to do with what who God is. Who God is. Who God is. And we realize this today, that the more you know Him, the easier it is for you to worship. So you have to know Him for yourself, to worship Him better. Now, Psalms 95, verses number 6 and 7. Some of the things that the Bible commands us to do in worship. Come, let's bow down in what? So, worship has to do also with bowing. How many of you here in your lifetime, in your worship with God, you have never cried? There's no wrong answers, by the way. But I can tell you, anyone who has ever come close to God enough, at one point, God, your emotions are moved. Because worship is about Him, not what He does. So, reason why we don't worship well is because
kubanga
we assume that we are going to worship Him
because
of the mountain He has moved. Psalm 95 commands us to do a couple of things. Number one, bowing. Number two, let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. But there's something I want to say today, and it is prophetic for somebody. As long as you bow and kneel before God, you will never bow before any man for any reason. Let God take all your worship. Verse number 7. Let God take all your worship.
So,
why do we bow and kneel?
For,
read with me, for what?
Come
on, let's be together.
For He is our God. And we are the people of His pasture.
Yes.
The flock under His care.
Yes.
Today,
now, reason why we worship Him, because we have come to an understanding that for us, this is our God.
ife.
Ono ye katonda wafe.
And we are people of his pasture.
Era tuli ndiga za dundiro lye.
And we are under his care.
Era tuli wansi wa bulabirizibwe.
I want to let you know.
Njagala kubategeza.
I love the government.
Njagala nyo government.
But I'm under the care of God.
Na ndi wansi wa bulabirizibwa katonda.
I know you have security men at your house.
Nyo linaba kume uwo jobera.
But we are under the care of the Lord.
Na ye katonda ya tulabirire na ya tukuma.
I know you are a good driver on this road.
Obuka bulunji nyo kunguta.
But we are under the care of the Lord. Those borders. My God. Oh my God.
Yes, sir.
How many of you are like me? Every time I'm in the car.
I have to see a border and I hold myself so tight. You see a border rider and you feel, my God.
We are under the care of what? Even that is enough to worship him. How have you survived in the city when you are alone? You're still in the city.
The things that have happened to you are enough to take people back to the village.
But blessed be the name of our God. Is able to keep you in the city. You must say, I'm under the care of the Lord.
Raise your hand and send you one.
I don't hear you say, Lord,
Gamba,
I'm so glad I'm under your care. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Christ.
So worship gestures include bowing down, kneeling. This has got to do nothing with culture.
Kino tekikwata ku ngeri gye wakuzibwamu oba
neyisa y'abantu.
Kino kya bwakatonda era kya Bayibuli.
These ideas of bachiga don't kneel.
Bino ebirowo bye tuogera mbu abachiga tebafukamira.
Before God.
Mu maaso ga Katonda.
There is a command that we must kneel before God.
Waliwo ekiragiro nti tuteekwa okufukamira mu maaso ge.
Have you ever knelt before the Lord? When you're not praying for anything, but worshiping Him? I'm calling upon you. We are going to worship Him. The other action that God calls for is lifting up hands. Psalms 134 and verse number 2. God says,
Katonda agamba,
lift up your hands in the sanctuary and praise the Lord. So this thing you see us lifting up hands, it is not just because we are under arrest. No, we lift up our hands in the sanctuary because it is a command from the Lord. Lifting up hands is a biblical command of worship.
Because there are people who became born again here. You found us raising our hands and you just joined us. And we usually command you. Raise your hands up. So you raise them.
Seconds.
And after 10 seconds, you take them down a notch.
Seconds.
5 other seconds. You say, but
eh?
Why should I die?
But worship.
Na yoku sinza.
It negates that we lift up our hands.
Kula gida nti tuyimuse mikono jafe.
And God is calling us to a place of worship.
Era Katonda atuita okuja mu kifo choku sinza.
Today.
Lero.
With our hands lifted in the evening.
Ne mikono jafe nga tujiweni sakaunge.
Heaven will know who deserves lifted hands.
Ekulu jija kumanyani agwani de okuyimusiwe mikono.
Listen.
Mu did he say?
Even in secular concerts, people lift up hands.
Nemo concert yezensi abantu mikono baji musa.
Have you listened to them?
Wadi oba labi yeko.
There used to be a concert by Mike Jackson.
Wadinga u concert ya Michael Jackson.
He used to sing.
Ya imbanga.
People would lift their hands.
Ngabantu bayi musa mikono jabo.
And worship something.
Ne baba koche basinza.
They would even pass out.
Ngabamu no kufaint. Oku bavako.
You would see a concert and women are being carried out.
Ngolaba concert abakazi babeti kababa fulumi.
Demons have entered them.
Ngemizimu jiba yingide.
But for us, our hands are raised up to the Lord. Raise your hands and say, Lord, my hands are raised up to you. All the days of my life, it is you that I will honor. Praise the Lord. Psalms 144, verses 1 and verse number 2. Praise be to the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle. Verse number 2. He's my loving God, my fortress and my stronghold, my deliverer, my shield, in whom I take refuge, who subdues people under me. When you lift up your hands, one of the things God will do, He will never let anyone subdue you, but He shall subdue men under your feet. In the glorious name of Jesus Christ. Number 3. Worship is a heart service.
Okusinza mbera oba service ya mutima.
Tugene neighbor kubanga sanda atenjikiriza mugambe pastor agambye.
Talk to your neighbor and tell them.
Okusinza kwa mutima.
Worship is a matter of the heart.
Let me also correct you.
Era kankutereze.
Worship songs.
Enyimba ezokusinza
is not worship.
Sikusinza.
Okusikwe kusinza.
That is not worship.
Worship songs are a manifestation of a worshiping heart.
Enyimba ezokusinza ziraga mutima ogusinza.
As a matter of fact, the composers were in a place of worship. And they got the language to talk to God. This morning I was telling the church, not all singers are worshippers. Some singers are simply singers. In fact, there are some of us who are worshippers that have no voice. But God somehow favors our worship. Because we are worshippers and not necessarily singers. Has somebody ever sang so well? And you don't seem to be moved in worship. But the voice is good. Good. The lyrics are right.
But something is missing.
Because worship is an atmosphere, not a gift. It's what you create by the reverence of your heart and not by your voice. So many singers, many worship leaders, focus so much on how they sound to us, and they forget how they sound to God. This is why many people lead worship, walk in ministry, and walk with unrepentant sin, but they still do their gift. But the environment can never work. Because I can sing whether I fornicated yesterday, but the environment of worship is going to come by my connection to the Holy Spirit. It is, therefore it is incumbent upon me to seek the presence of God. Do you know something? There are people here today. Your worship, because it is from the heart, it is going to touch the heart of the Holy Ghost.
And I see when the Holy Spirit has visited you.
Amina.
Amen.
Neighbor Mugambe, basinza na mutima.
Tell your neighbor, we can only worship with our heart. We do not worship with songs. Songs are as manifestation of what is in the heart.
You know why you have never cried before God in worship? Because your worship is lip service. And by the way, singers hear me, worshippers. You can never lead people where you have never been.
Abantu tosobola balungamya n'obatuusa ggwe gy'otatuukanga.
No matter how much you see.
Si nsonga oyimba kyenkana ki.
And people look at you.
Abantu ne bakutunuulira.
Because you're not carrying them.
Kubanga toibetise.
To take them to the presence of God.
Kubatwala mukubelawo kwa Katonda.
By the can I tell you something?
Era nkubulire.
The day you truly embrace the presence of God.
Olunaku lwolikiriza okubelawo kwa Katonda.
There are things about you that will change without asking
anyone. Waliwe bintu kubulamu bwo bijjo kuchuka ngatoina nacho sabye.
Do you see that habit that has clung on you?
Olaba muzogo ogukulemedde kogo.
You worship God.
Kwesinza Katonda.
Keep yourself in the presence.
Wenyike mukubelawo kwe.
Every time you draw close.
Bulilwa sembera.
The devil runs away.
Emizimu sitani aduka.
Our God will give us power from the stronghold. Somebody shout, you're my deliverer. Raise your hand and say,
dear Lord,
you
are my deliverer.
God wants authentic worship. And I thought in this kind of service, worshippers will be with their notebooks writing everything I'm saying. But probably you have no dream of letting people worship. How many of you saw recently this man of God called
Eze?
He was in London worshipping.
Yadi London ngasinza.
He filled that Wembley Stadium.
Najuza Wembley Stadium.
It's a bit bigger than Nambole.
Wembley neno kusinga ku Nambole.
But in London.
Na ye mu London.
In England.
Mu England.
To feel that kind of stadium.
Oh, kujuze tsawe che chikange.
From Africa.
Ngovude mu Africa.
Something has changed.
Wali we chibachi chuse.
And he's a young man.
Na yenga muvubuka muto.
He's not even 40 years.
Taweza wadde miaka ana.
But in worship,
naye kusinza,
in connection to God,
mukweyunga ku Katonda,
people were being healed.
Abantu ne bawonyezebwa.
Literally, as he was worshiping, testimonies were coming. Somebody's leaving the wheelchair. People are leaping out. Because the Bible says, God dwells in the praises of his people. Let me help every worship leader. You cannot lead us for an hour of worship. If you cannot spend 3 hours of worship alone. Also, note this, please. The devil took your worship a long time ago. And he left you with songs.
For most of you in the service, there is something else you worship. In church, all you bring is a song. But when your heart is so far away,
something I've learned over time. The spiritual realm is more than lip service. That is why many people can sing all their life
abantu banji basobola kuyimba obulamu bwabo bonna
and never change
ne batachuka ne batabako che
bachuka.
I wonder
emizimu miyai.
Demons are such liars
because
I love soccer so much
and soccer is 90 minutes.
Yeah.
Sometimes 105. But women, we can watch. We watch the game. We watch the comments before the game. How the game will be. That is 1 hour. The game will be like this. Then we watch the game. We see all the goals. Then we watch the analysis. But we watched it. But the same thing for women. They can watch their soap.
She watches
and repeats where she watched even tomorrow.
Na yego chimanyi.
But do you know?
When you say I'm going to worship God.
Bo gamba ntingenda kusinza Katonda.
You worship.
When you check the time.
15 minutes later.
Nga wakaita wedda chika 15 zoka.
Nigo uliro okoye.
But you feel exhausted.
Because the enemy. The devil knows the power of your worship.
Kubanga sitani amanya amanya gadi mkusinza ako.
Now,
kati
number 3.
Echo kusatu.
Worship is not a lip service.
Okusinza techiba chikolwa cha mimwa cho.
Worship is a heart service.
Okusinza chiba chikolwa cha mutima.
Isaiah 29 verses number 13.
Isaiah 29:13.
Isaiah 29 verse 13.
Isaiah 29:13.
They come near me with their mouth. They honor me with their lips. But their hearts are where? Afar. Their worship of me is made only of rules taught by men. In fact, some people have never really worshipped God. They even have special songs. So, like if a worshiper is worshipping.
Omusinza, for example, waba sinza.
Leka kalosa.
They shout for the song.
Because
they love it.
Nenga
tasinza Katonda. But they are not worshipping God.
Emitima.
The hearts.
Yentandi kwa yoku sinza.
At where worship begins.
You know that you can sing and talk for 10 years.
Ochimanyi ntosobola kuyimba no yogero kumale miaka 10.
And you have never given God your heart.
Ngakatonda tomuwanga koko mutima gwo.
Twale chitiwa. Twalobuyiza. Ha.
As you worship, as you're singing, you remember what you didn't do. My Irish potatoes. Should I call Mama Nakanwaji to help me take them off the fire?
Mama Naka.
The Irish have left on the charcoal stove. Please help me reduce the fire. It will get burnt. And then you continue in worship.
What is the longest time you have ever worshipped God alone?
Booze, ask somebody, what your sins is akumala banga chi obuwanvu when there is nobody leading you.
Nkusabide yo season. Rona yingira mukasenge.
I am praying for season when you'll be able to enter in a room.
Katonda nakaa.
And the Lord will come down.
Omoyo wa mukama nakuambatira.
And the Holy Spirit will come upon you.
Ngoliweka.
When you are alone.
You know what I feel in my heart?
Omanche mpulira mutima gwange.
This coming year.
Guno mwako guja.
2025.
Biri abiri mweta.
There are some people that even if you imprison them.
Wali wa bantu abamunga ne bwoba obasibye mukomera.
Their relationship with the Holy Spirit.
Kolagana ya we no moyo mutuku.
Is enough to bring them out without your permission.
Ebalo kubajja yonga kwetokiriza kubata.
Wali one chibina
chaba. There is even a congregation. Even though you hate them.
Yamalo kwelo ba muri nyali amoka.
Already anchored in the name of the Lord.
I give you a revelation. In such worship meetings
in West Yezokusinza,
come with what we call a worship sacrifice. That is only when you can bring your heart. That is the only time. In Jesus' mighty name. Clap your hands and thank the Holy Spirit.